What's up, everybody? So in this video, we're going to be talking about everything that you need to know for D1.2HL. So the whole cell and nuclear division thing. But in this video, we're really going to focus on cell cycle and cyclins in much more detail, and also cancer. Now, if you guys have anxiety in light of the recent movie Inside Out 2, you guys should go check out TeachMe.org. We got lots of awesome IB style questions and sexy, super awesome notes just for you guys. Go check them out. They'll help you out so much and relieve your anxiety before these final exams. Now, without further ado, let's get your anxiety over with and watch this video. So, real quick, we're going to recap mitosis and meiosis in like 1 minute, and then we're going to talk a little bit about the purposes of mitosis in a tad more detail than you guys had to know for SL, and then all the rest, the HL stuff, right? So let's quickly run over this because it's straightforward and I just want to test you guys on it. So what is mitosis, guys? It is the production of two genetically identical cells, making a clone of a cell, right? What about meiosis? Completely different. The production of sex cells, right? Like spermie and eggy, right? Two completely different things. Now, what's the purpose of meiosis, right? We need to make sperm and egg, and that's very important for reproduction, right? Sexual reproduction, to be able to make kids and pass on your genetic information. And no, not this kind of egg. Now, quickly, mitosis, what's the purpose? There are two very broad categories, repair and growth. So repair is straightforward. You get damaged, you hurt yourself. Let's take your skin as an example, okay? Doesn't just apply to your skin, but you've got many layers of skin. So the top part is your superficial layer, the part closest to the outside. So if we look at his finger, it'd be the top part. And as we go deeper through your skin, there's many layers, and eventually we get to little blood vessels, right? If you get stabbed, right, as you try to make that brownie or chop that cake up, you stab all the way through. You go from the top, you stab through, you eventually hit a little blood vessel. Now you'll bleed and all the blood will come out and you'll faint, or you'll pass out if you're me. Now, so you gotta know, how is this relevant to mitosis? Because these cells that are deep, these cells are mitotic cells. They are stem cells that can divide and divide and divide. Now, as they divide, new cells divide under them. So then these cells start pushing up. So all these cells up here, they are older cells, okay? They're older cells, and they're so far away from the blood vessel that they end up dying because they don't get enough nutrition, and so they flake off and they fall off. You may have seen that when your skin falls off, right? So that's very, very important. And your skin, remember, it just serves as a nice barrier to infection and protects you from the outside world a little bit as a barrier. Okay, but just understand the mitosis purpose. These cells deep can divide and divide and form new cells. And as they divide, they push the old cells up to superficially. Okay, so it's a whole cycle, very important. And then for growth, very important, right? You got your sperm cell, your egg cell, they fuse to make a zygote. And this stem cell will divide by what? Mitosis over and over again to form an embryo. And those cells will divide by themselves, forming a bigger thing, and eventually have a baby, and all those cells will differentiate to become brain cells, skin cells, liver cells, whatever, all those things, right? So just understand the role of mitosis in growth and repair. Now, we also, unfortunately, got to talk a little bit about plants, because we talked only about humans, but there's a section you guys need to understand from the book about mitosis in plants. I don't love plants, unfortunately, but you know, life's life, and the IB wants you to know it, so let's just know it. So mitosis, plants have two cool regions called two special areas, kinds of areas called meristems, and these are areas that have very special cells, okay, called stem cells, and these cells can divide and divide by mitosis, right? So there are two kinds of areas we need to know about: the apical meristem and the lateral meristem. The apical meristem, see that little branch coming off there? It's not a leaf, it's a meristem. Now this area is special because it's made up of a lot of stem cells, and it can divide and divide and divide. And what's the purpose of that? It's to cause the plant to lengthen, to become longer, to increase in height. And these areas, these apical meristems, are always located at the apex, so the very tip, either of the stem, the tip of the stem, or the tip of the root. Because not only does the stem need to increase in length, but also the root to go deeper, to get more water, right? To survive. Now, what's the difference between the apical meristem, this little specialized area of stem cells, and the lateral meristem. The lateral meristem you can't see because it's inside the stem. It's on the peripheral of the stem, the inside, but on the side boundaries, on the side of the stem. And they, when they proliferate, they cause the plant to get wider. So they cause the plant to increase in width. So you can see it's located at the lateral side of the stems. You can't see it here, but it's inside the stems, or the lateral side of the roots, causing it to become wider. Now, real quick, we should be able to look at this whole area under a light microscope, and we'll see something pretty interesting. It looks vaguely like this. You can see a lot of cells that are undergoing mitosis because you can see their nuclei, these cells, are condensed. When they're condensed, what does that mean? That means they're actively dividing, right? The dark spots represent condensed chromosomes inside cells which are rapidly undergoing mitosis. So these areas are just stem cells dividing and dividing and dividing and dividing, right? Over and over again. But eventually, okay? So you should know that they are undifferentiated because they are stem cells. So they don't have any specific function just yet. But later on, they can differentiate. So initially, they're just dividing to make the plant bigger. But later on, those stem cells can differentiate and start undergoing a specific role, whether it be structural to keep the plant nice and sturdy, whether it be to become a xylem or a phloem, to be able to carry sugars and water around the plant, whatever, right? So that's very important. So that's how mitosis is involved in plants, how plants grow, thanks to these meristems. Now here's a realistic micrograph image for you guys. You guys should know, see here, this area here, all these little nuclei, condensed nuclei, indicating that mitosis is happening, prophase, metaphase, all that good stuff from SO, dividing and dividing and dividing, and it causes the plant to get longer and longer, and all these cells below that area is starting to differentiate and become their true purpose, okay, whether it be structural or transport, okay, so that was it. We quickly rushed over this little boring-ish part for you guys, the purpose, okay, of mitosis. So now we can get into the real nitty-gritty details here, the cell cycle and so on. So do you guys remember anything about cell cycle? Remember, we covered it briefly in standard level, but really now you gotta like nail it for higher level, okay? For access to our full-length premium videos and so much more, head over to teachme.org now.